Shawty, I cutie and hoodie. Got it all figured out. That's what they all say, yeah. Everyone's looking at me thinking that I'm different. Everyone's looking at me thinking that I'm living. But I don't really care what they all say. Hi guys, my name is Eddie McKenzie. I'm an international student from Mozambique and I am a freshman at Princeton University. So today I'm here to talk all about the key mistakes that every single person does on your essay. Yes, when I say everyone, I'm talking about you. I'm directly talking to you, no one else. I'm talking to you. Over the past year and a half, I've been reading a ton of like college entry type essays, right? So like for people that just ask me for my guidance. Now, right now, like I literally can't go doing like one-on-one mentoring anymore. So like I thought that this video would be amazing because here are the mistakes that you can like fix right now on your essays without me having to read them specifically and saying, okay, here is the mistake. So yeah, just take this with a grain of salt, and of course always put like your words, your passion into it, and like your personality into it. But like I hope that you find this video helpful. This is all that I have to say, so let's get into this. The first mistake that I see a lot of people doing is like making the essay about everyone else and everything else but themselves. So today's video is done in collaboration with Essay Edge. I'm really excited for this collaboration because a lot of you have been reaching out to me asking me to review your essays, go over your essays, like grammatical errors, coherence, or like overall just seeing if your essays are good enough. First of all, like your essays are good enough because you're like great, but if you want to go the extra step and see what minimal mistakes or minimal errors that you can fix in your essays, or like which words and phrases and paragraphs could be better done, you can go to Essay Edge. I will leave the link down below. It's a really great essay editing company, and it's not only for admission essays, although like most of you are probably year four this, but they also like go over resumes, academic papers, like literally everything. If you're looking for a summer type internship, like you have like this paper that is due like 3 days from now, but you're not sure if it's good enough, you could go to the Essay Edge page, which I will leave the link down below, and they will go over your essay. The turnaround time is really quick, 2 days, 48 hours max. And you also be supporting your girl, so like 1, 2, 3. Two birds with one stone. So yeah, definitely check the link down below and go over what services they do have, and if you enjoy them you can purchase them and like get your essay within 48 hours, which I bet that's what you all want. And if you don't, like at least you saw what options there were, definitely check them out. Now back to the video. Even when they ask me why do you want to go to that school, you still need to tell them like why you are the great fit for that school, not just rambling on about how it's because this school is amazing, they have this and this and this and that, and not putting 1 ounce on how you would participate into that. So they already know that they have the facilities, that they have the professors, that they are renowned, that they have this and this and that. But like in reality, when they're asking you that question, they want to know how you would participate into all of that, and how your person, your amazing and incredible person, would contribute positivity into that whole like campus atmosphere and campus community. And like even when they ask you like talk about someone that is meaningful to you, in reality they just want to know like how has that person influenced you, so what reflections do you have. Like something that I always say is that you need to be as reflective as possible on your essays.
like, you can't just go out there like stating facts, like this and this and that and this and this and that. You need to be reflective, like, okay, you're telling me all of this story, you're telling me all of this, but why is this meaningful? Why does this matter to you? How has this changed your mindset, the person that you are? Like, how has this contributed into you being this awesome person, or you being as passionate as you are about all of these things that you're passionate about? And how has this experience possibly changed your outlook on life, or what you want to be after you go into college, like the types of things that you want to be doing? That's my first tip. Be as reflective as possible, and always remember that they want to hear about you. They want to hear, why is this person so freaking amazing for our school, and how we wouldn't be able to survive without them, because we need them right now. So put your all of your personality into your essay. And this is something that I always emphasize, and if you've been here for some time now, you're like probably tired of me saying this, but like, showing your personality is literally so damn important. Doubt that they would be like interested in me, because without that, okay, what are you seeing? You're just seeing like a piece of paper. You need to make that piece of paper as interesting and engaging as possible. The second mistake that I see a lot of people doing is that they make like the essay dark, and then more dark, and then even darker. Suddenly we're at the end and like, okay, the positivity has come out, like, okay, now I'm better. But throughout 80% of the essay, you were just talking about dark and dark and dark and dark. Like, you did not reflect on all of that. What I'm saying is not, of course, for you to not put about like your obstacles and like your challenges, because they want to hear that, of course. But when you write about those types of things, you always need to be reflective. You always need to connect that back to you, and always connect that back to how your mindset is changing, you know? I'm not just going to talk about like the entirety of my essay about me being sick. I'm going to talk about like the reflections that came with me being sick, perhaps. Like me starting to value more of like the other types of things, or maybe like the challenge between me like trying to adjust to this like new lifestyle that was completely different, of course, because I was sick. But you shouldn't just make like a super negative essay throughout all of the essay. Like, no, please do not do that. Please do not do that. Try to focus more on how this is important and not what happened. It literally does not have to be big. It doesn't need to be like an outrageous, like big, extraordinary, like life-shifting event. No, it does not. It absolutely does not need to be that deep. And another thing that comes out in the note of like being foremost as hell is like people writing about things that they think the reader wants to read. Like, everything that I'm talking about is about my own experience and things that I think are like important or relevant, right? But like, literally, you never really know, right? So there are a lot of people, like literally a lot of people, that try to write what they think the readers want to see. Please do not do that. And one advice that I actually gave to a friend of mine, right, that is applying to college this year, and I had completely forgotten about that, and the advice that I gave to her is, write your draft of your essay first, and then look at the prompts. You're like bound free. You're bound free. You're just writing. You're just charging up. You're just putting everything that is on your mind, your thoughts, things that you think that are important, what is relevant, like how that shifted your mindset, how your mind works. Like, that's something that they really want to know. How does your mind work? Because I think that how your mind works is something that is literally so damn important. Like, how does your cerebrum work, girl? And then you have like a rough estimate of what you want to see, usually, because you have like all of this, and then you round it up to an overall topic, and you see, okay, this essay is about this and this, so like, now let me refine it. So now let me go to the essay prompt and see like what this essay best like allocates itself to, right? Because there are like 8 prompts, if I'm not mistaken. So you see like which prompt like goes best with your essay, like them knowing who you are, like as much as possible, like your values, your responsibilities, what you value, the people you love, what you're interested in, what makes you spark and dartle and just run it up. Them getting to know who you are and not what you think they want you to be. And that also goes to life, like reflections with Erin right here. Like, if you're trying to be what everyone else wants you to be, you will not be living. Like, is it really worth it in the end to sacrifice your well-being, to sacrifice yourself, your individuality, your personality, to fill this mold of people want you to be? No, shawty. Like, it literally isn't. Most often than not, like when I'm looking at the essays, I'm not really looking much at the grammar. Like, okay, if there are 2 like essays, right, this is grammatically perfect, but like the storyline is meh. And then there is this essay that has like maybe 5 words that are like badly allocated, but the storyline is literally incredible, and the storyline like keeps you engaged. Like, you need to keep your readers engaged, because attention span is literally so damn quick, and you are wowed, literally wowed by that person. Like, I would literally forget about this essay that is formally perfect, but like, really going into the like stylistic methods and how your overarching theme is like something that you really need to focus about when you're like going throughout your essay like again and again, right? I can't tell you what to write, of course, because you are the one that knows yourself in your essay and what you want to be, but I feel like that's like something important to take into consideration. And the last mistake is not engaging your reader into the story. But like, how do you engage your reader into the story? How? And that goes with my tip, that is, be as descriptive as Mozart. I feel like that's the kind of mindset that you need to have, right? So you're like, okay, how do I make this interesting? How do I like portray my story in the most engaging way possible? So like, be descriptive and like specific. You need to be specific to you. Like, the story needs to be specific to you. If I can read this essay and think that it's like Fulano de Shishi, Fulano de Ibsen, and all of these other people, like, you need to revise that essay, because there isn't enough of you in that essay. What were your emotions that day? Like, what was going through your mind? How were you like, how was your party feeling? Were you all over the place? Were you excited? Were you sad? Were you frightened? What? Like, you know, when you're watching a movie or like reading a really good book, like the way that they keep you engaged, like, try to do that in your essay. Like, literally give me the shrivels when I like I'm reading your essay. Like, make me cry if it's needed to, bro. Like, I'm here with my tissues. Like, just ice them out. If you want more tips relating to essays that are like more specific, that I have a couple of videos down below. And if you want like a part 2 to this video, or want anything else that is like related to essays, reach out. Let's go. E to the G.
Plan so you don't worry. You ain't gotta come to conclusions this early.